Another day on my local mountain trails. I was a bit bugged the last time I was up on the top section of Wages of Sin that I couldn't make it up in one try. I needed to know for myself if it was due to the extremely slippery conditions or if I was still doing something seriously wrong. And of course, I mean doing things wrong as a beginner in this type of riding on a trail spike, as I'm well aware that expert riders would consider 90% of what I'm doing just wrong.
So here I am, midway on the top half of Wages of Sin. It's the hill we did last weekend, and I'm doing today what I said I wasn't going to do. I'm riding by myself, but it bugged me that I couldn't do this hill. So we've had a whole entire week of rain, pouring rain. It's washed away a lot of that crappy, silty mud. So I see a couple of people that have come down this hill today. It's a little scratched up. Maybe I can do it. Let's have a good try at it. Plus, I lowered the tire pressure in the back tire down to 2 psi. So I'm looking for a nice fat footprint. Anyways, enough chatting. Let's see if we can do this. Still really slippery. Just get over top of this hump here. Did it, but I sat on the damn fender. So, not really much better than last time. I didn't have any time all week to practice, so I guess I get what I deserve.
This is a trail that I've never been on. I've ridden up to it several times in the past, but never explored where it goes. Some of these trails can look the same in sections, so it can be a bit confusing as there's just so much to ride up here. A guy could spend several days in a row riding and never get to all the trails. Okay, so I guess I have been here before, because I remember turning around at this point. Let's see where this trail goes.
Well, that's a tough little bugger.
I tend to get stuck in one particular gear with this awesome little bike. It's just so easy to drop it in third and clutch it through everything. First gear never gets used, second gear is still a little bit crazy, but third and fourth work very well up here and in this type of riding. Fifth gear, it can be used going downhill on a road with a tailwind that is just about all it's good for. So that being said, I need to remember to take advantage of first and second a bit more often now that my balance is getting better.
All right, let's try this in second. That's better. Try barrel trail. Bother with that.
I need to do a better job sometimes of looking for alternate lines. One tends to look at the beaten path a bit too much and you get lured into sections like this. Could have probably ridden around this with a lot less effort.
Yeah. this is Olga. She's an ornery bitch.
In my opinion, something that is never stressed enough on training videos is the actual importance of being comfortable at the balance point of a wheelie. It's always looked at as a fun trick instead of a necessary advanced technique, when in fact that's exactly what it is. You cannot ride up steep inclines and rocks without, well, you can't do it well without being comfortable on your back wheel. On a trials bike, this means stand-up wheelies, of course. I'm just not that comfortable there yet, and it's something that is holding me back. I can do it, but still get nervous. Covering the rear brake while negotiating these hills, rocks, roots, and everything else, keeping the front end high, traction on the rear without looping it, is way harder than it looks.
Well, I don't know what that was. Besides a mistake.
What you don't see here on the GoPro footage is how much my front wheel is in the air. I find it way easier to do most of this stuff solely on the rear wheel. A little lift with the knees is all it takes with this bike to loft the front end up. From that point on, it's just a matter of balance and skill for how long and how far you wish to go. But it takes real nerve to hold that wheel up when riding technical sections.
Dabbed a foot finally. That's a pretty good run though. Put my foot down there again. Thank you.
Riding down hills on this bike is a blast. I've discovered that the best way to do it is just to drop it into fourth for moments when you need a nudge from the motor, but otherwise just ride it like a mountain bike with a clutch in. McNutt has a few great downhill sections, and I look forward to doing them now on the Sherco. The Husaberg, not so much.
We haven't done Holy Smoke in a while. In case you haven't figured out from some of my videos, McNutt has over 100 kilometers of trails. It's a giant hill. They're all, well, most of them are quite well maintained, but they're all pretty gnarly. There's probably a dozen trails on here that I've never even been to yet. Strictly due to lack of talent so far. For example, the line, I can't get up either one of those. And there's trails up at the top that you have to be able to even get to. Either a factor of gas or extreme difficulty. Whew. Yeah. Sweet. Quite like that before. There's a little burnt rubber. That was cool. That would have really sucked to fall off of though. Well, you don't think about those things, right? Especially when you're out riding by yourself. Might as well go for a little blip up museum. Damn. Fail. got a little high centered. Guess I should have been on the back wheel a little bit more.
That was fun, but need to be real careful not to let the clutch out when going faster than the gear I was in. Been another great day's ride.